And here is my old face, without makeup. Here we go. But I'm 69 years old, so this is what you get, I suppose. But I'm working on it. I'm working on this turkey neck. And the major wrinkles I have here in my face and neck is because I've lost weight. So, you know, six of one and half a dozen of the other. But I'm getting there. I'm starting to tighten the neck a little bit. I need to work on the face. And I would consider, I suppose if I could afford it, I would consider a facelift. But I'm hoping that once I get, you know, once my hormones really kick in, that they will start filling out my face again. But otherwise, I'm doing pretty well. I'm about to present my latest musical, Blue Bonnet Road, at the end of this month, in various places here in Austin, Texas, and I feel really good about that. And with a little makeup, I don't look quite so old. But here I am in the raw, as it were. Nice breast development. I don't know if you call this a B cup or a C cup, but it's definitely breast development. Yeah. And since my breast is still kind of sore around the nipples, that means they're still growing. So definitely something to look forward to. So I could just put another head on this body, I might turn out okay. But we'll see what happens. The other thing I want to talk about, oh, this gets hard to hold up with one hand. I'm switching hands here. The other thing I want to talk about is my evolution, or evolution, as the British say, and they should know because Darwin was British, you know. From the side that looks too naked. All right. Anywho, back in the 70s when I started my transition, my first transition, I had different views than I have now, and I've changed a great deal in the last few months since I've been watching. My hair is terrible, and I washed it yesterday. Since I've been watching transgender videos on YouTube, of course, almost everybody's in their 20s or 30s, and I've gone past that many years ago. So I should not compare myself to the young people. And yet, I'm not like someone who's going through this at the age of 50 or 60. I had my SRS when I was 29 in September of that year. So I was part of that demographic once. And I've lived a stealth life. I've done very well. Once in a while someone would clock me, as the young people say, but very seldom. And I got through a career with the state of Texas for almost 30 years. Well, more than 30 years, but 30 years account on my pension, because I I had two brief jobs that I, oh good, I can do it this way. Two brief jobs that I cashed in on too early, or I would be getting a higher pension now. So I was able to retire, and I've done things in retirement that I wasn't able to do before. I was able, and I did for a while, get back on HRT, but 20 years passed, and after retirement, I started my third transition with HRT. All that time, I did okay. I was treated as a woman and mostly with respect. And I do kind of suspect that my final supervisor I don't know, she may have been transphobic. I have a feeling that I was dismissed a couple of years early because of her, because I did everything she asked me to do, and I even went above and beyond, and yet I was still kind of forced out. But I had earned retirement. I had been in the job long enough, and I had reached the age at which I could retire anyway. So, no major regrets. But I always thought that what I had, just a little bit of breast development and, loss of facial hair after electrolysis 35 years ago, and I had friends, and I had a job and everything, and I had a boyfriend for over 20 years, but that's another story. We'll tell it another time, I think. So I did pretty well for myself, but I did not know how much further I could have gone if I had only stayed on HRT. But I had really no one to tell me until I saw on the internet these young women who were able to, get actual female hips and a small waist and all that. And not just with the corset training and surgery and all. And now I see that I was able to get more breast development, as you can see, with HRT. And I think that I'm on my way to a female waist and hip situation, which is really cool. And early in my third transition, I said to my cousin, who is a state representative and a liberal state representative in Texas, Austin, Texas, to be sure, but she took over a post that had been occupied by Republicans for several years. So I am really proud of her for that, and for her stance on liberal issues and human issues, basically, which are liberal issues. But I told her, at least through email, that when she brought up the transgender issue, I said I didn't like the term transgender because it incorporated too many people who are not the same as me. Because all I knew was what the general public thought, which was that transgender people, transsexuals, are considered in the same category as drag queens and transvestites. And it's just not true. But I found out from the transgender community that transgender means just that, someone who is transitioning from one gender to the other. And that's all it is. It's not somebody who is pretending. It's not for somebody who's dressing up. It's not for somebody who puts on a lot of makeup and does a show for people to gawk at. It's for someone who's actually making the transition, trying to live a life. And that's the way I see it now. And now that I've been acculturated to the term transgender, I embrace it now. And maybe it is a little less harsh than transsexual, which I suppose I am as well, having actually gone through the transition with the sexual reassignment surgery. So that is where I am right now. And now that I have a selfie and a selfie stick, I can tell my story honestly, in the raw, as it were, and maybe sometimes with a little bit more makeup on. And I have none on right now, not even lipstick, you know. And I will go back to my stealth channel, I Need a Band with the Wheeze, where I will wear makeup and I will not talk about transgender issues. It's open to the entire world to see. This is unlisted, but I suppose it's open to the entire world, but they would have to look for it anyway. So that's it for now. That's my state of the body vlog. Third transition vlog number 8 by the Wheeze. And I hope you subscribe below and like it, I hope. And don't comment too harshly. Be kind. Because I've gone through a lot. And I have a lot more to go through. So, as an aging girl, I say goodbye, YouTube. Oh my God. Oh, here we go.